For centuries, a war has been waged in the shadows by two armies born of incredible powers. And yet, it is said there lives a warrior with the ability to tip the balance between good and evil. But first, she must choose.
At the beginning of Elektra, she has been through the darkest period of her life, and that's where we actually start the meat of the movie.
There's a wall of ice around her, and she has herself so isolated from the outside world that she doesn't even know she's isolated anymore.
Stick is the traditional sensei in martial arts, and Elektra is probably the most promising pupil that he could ever come across. But she doesn't want to do what he tells her. She's the bad apple, she's the difficult pupil.
You understand violence and pain, but you do not know the way.
Teach me then.
That's my point. I can't teach you.
She has so much rage in her life that Stick kicks her out of his compound. And then she puts that much discipline and focus on becoming an assassin.
I'll call you when you get the target.
I'm Mark Miller. We're in the little cabin, two houses down.
Her name's Elektra, Dad.
Like the tragedy. Your parents must have had a sense of humor.
Not really.
Abby really connects to Elektra, and she thinks that Elektra's the coolest thing that's ever happened. She's a fighter, too. I look up to her so much, I kind of get caught up in the moment and really want to be around her.
I like your bracelet, by the way. Do you know what those are? They're warrior beads. They're from Indonesia. Centuries ago, you had to be the best fighter in your village to earn them.
I bought them off eBay.
Where's her mother?
She died a couple of years ago.
My mother died when I was young.
As soon as we sort of become a little bit closer, some kind of, like, major bad thing happens that we actually can't express ourselves to each other.
I'm not a good person to get involved with.
The target package has arrived.
She's extremely haunted. Her past is catching up with her, and her deeds are catching up with her, and feelings of guilt are starting to sort of fester inside of her.
I'm not gonna do it.
They'll just send somebody else, eh?
Go! Dad! There'll be more coming.
The people who are after her, these black magic villains, have a very, very unique arsenal. There's a lot of imagination in the movie.
The fun thing about our villains, they are all specialists in one crazy way or another. We have Kurigi, who's the head of this break-off group who comes hunting Elektra and Abby and Mark. He's played by William Lee. He's a martial artist turned actor, not the other way around. He is the real deal. Ah! We have Typhoid Mary, who kills you with a kiss.
Typhoid Mary has been a great character, a psychotic, fun character in the Elektra universe.
You have Bob Sapp as Stone, who, I don't know if you've ever seen Bob Sapp, but he would take up every bit of this room. His biceps are this big around, and he could literally pick me up and toss me like a bag of potatoes, which he did. And then you have Tattoo, where the tattoos on his body come to life and come after you with their own special powers. So these guys come at you from every angle. Elektra is pretty straightforward. She just is lethal and is gonna kill you. You know, these guys get you from directions you would never expect.
We put a team together that team alone worth the price of admission.
We have failed to solve the problem.
The task is yours, completed.
She does have an incredible maternal instinct that fills her up when she sees this little girl. But in protecting her, she puts her own life at risk.
Why did you really save them, Elektra? Some kind of down payment on your sins?
She saved my life and my daughter's. That's enough for me.
Now, Elektra, the time has come for you to decide.
Suddenly she has to confront who she is. Is she a killer? Is she a person who is normal? And if she is, then she has killed a lot of people. And how does somebody deal with that?
So you really used to kill people?
I'm a soccer mom.
The war is over.
The war has just begun.
In saving them when she is supposed to kill them, in putting her life on the line to protect this little girl, she finds her own humanity. And I love that. I think that's such a fantastic story to tell and to be a part of. I'm really, really proud of the fights that Mike Gunther choreographed.
Jennifer is, hands down, she's a rock star. She trains so hard in, you know, so many different disciplines. She's doing a little bit of boxing, a little bit of wushu, a little bit of just hard style martial arts like Shotokan. So it's kind of a little bit of everything, and we're walking that line and pushing the envelope.
When they said, do you want to have stunt rehearsal? I said, yes, I'll be there early.
For example, I learned to use a bow stick for a fight that we did earlier this week. I've been training for that several hours Saturday, several hours on Sunday for a couple of months now. It was so gratifying. At one point, they had these huge fans on me. All this hair was covering my eyes, and I was fighting blind against five guys.
I didn't know I'd be able to do that, you know, with the amount of prep that we had for the film.
But I was so rehearsed that I knew the fight would go right. There I was, I couldn't see anything, but I heard the click, click, click of my stick hitting theirs, and that was exhilarating. And that's why I trained so hard. They could blindfold me, they could hang me upside down, and I can do that fight.
In terms of the fighting, it was real physics. We did use wires for safety, but I didn't want it to sort of accidentally fall into a Chinese wire movie.
From the big fight between Elektra and Stone, we set up a mechanical tree that'll actually do the falling for us. And our mandate on the whole show is we're trying to make a superhero as exciting as possible and keep it within the realm of believability. So what we ended up doing is running a whole bunch of high lines over top of everybody in the trees. And what it is it's a series of winches. We had 5 winches there and 10 operators hidden in this little area there.
And pull!
I could not have made this movie without Jennifer's ethics and skills. There's an environment of, let's get our fingers dirty, let's get up early, let's work as hard as we can in each and every shot.
Both cameras are ready.
Now there's a sequence where the villain has got 2 swords, katanas, that are real, and she's got her size that are real, and they're going at it. And it's the 2 principal actors of the movie. And you're afforded the opportunity to put the camera on their faces in the middle of the fight and not just jump back to silhouettes of doubles.
We did not use our stunt doubles. The 2 of us went mano a mano, you know, which was really, really fun to do.
It just made it so much more believable and so much more real and kind of unique.
Action!
Comics have been created by very, very talented artists. And the one thing you want to do when you bring a character to film is make sure you are honoring them. And I always go to Marvel to make sure that the things we are doing have the resonance of what they want to see from their comics on the film screen. There are many, many Elektra variations in the comic world. In the beginning, we wanted Elektra's costume to be kind of simple and sports-oriented. In the end result, we went back to much more detail. The back is laced like a corset. The metal jewelry pieces say death. Her armband says assassin, and her belt says destiny.
We went really classic Elektra look. That is the color choice, the design choice, the ethnic influences on the fashion.
It was only natural that Elektra would wear the red that is really her trademark color. It was really important to me that we go back to more of her traditional look.
In terms of just the bright red, she's an assassin. Assassins wear black, so why is she wearing red? Because she doesn't care if they see her. She just feels that she's so superior to anybody that would try to stop her that she announces herself.
Here we are at last. I guess it's all true. The red outfit, the knives. So what happens now? You just kill me straight out, just cold?
Don't worry. That's not that bad.
Yeah. How do you know?
I died once.
I sort of felt there was a lot of swagger and bravado in it. And fine, here I am. Come get me. Try it. There's a really wonderful sort of fluidity and flow to everything. All of the costumes in this movie are gorgeous.
We have everything that is required in an action movie. We have these amazing bad guys. We have these nasty fights. We have, you know, great costumes and beautiful sets and crazy action. And ultimately, she finds out that she is a great person and a hero. And I think she's more surprised by that than anyone else.